He came out single with his daughters. And the last thing and the worst thing that happened was that he was even raped by the daughters. That was the end of him. But I want you to know that association and connection with the blessed, with the anointing, will always bring the blessings of God. So when we get out of the right location, we can dislocate ourselves from the flowing blessings of God. So one of the areas that we have to see is this area. When Lot left that place, he missed it. When Paul went to preach to the wrong people, he was persecuted and was beaten. But when he went to the rightful people that he has been ordained to minister to, there was success. Right location and the right time. Another person that I want to mention is Joseph. Joseph was in his father's land when he had a dream. And in the dream, the interpretation of his dream meant that his brethren was going to submit or bow to him or bow to his authority. And when they heard about that dream, they were so annoyed, they envied him, and then they decided that any chance that they get, they have to wipe him out of the surface of the earth. So to say that if that dream really come to pass. But what happened was that with all the plans that they had of killing him, they threw him in the pit when he came to bring them food in the field. After those suffering, God orchestrated things and he was brought out and sold as a slave into Egypt. All along, God was working out things in a way that he will come to the place that he has been located to be promoted to enjoy the blessings of God, as God has revealed. So during the suffering, he went through a whole lot of things. But as he was going through, the plans of God was unfolding in his life. I don't know where you are now in life, but I want to assure you that sometimes the things that you are going through, God is working things out for your good. Joseph landed himself in Potiphar's house, but because of the blessing over his life, because of the anointing, because of the favor, things in Potiphar's house was getting blessed day in and day out. So he was made the chief steward in the house. Everything was given into his hands to take over. And then it happened that Potiphar's wife tempted Joseph day and night, day by day. According to the Bible, he tried to force him to go to bed with him in order to abort the plans of God for Joseph's life. Sometimes many people don't realize the tricks of the enemy. When you get to some comfort zone, we think everything is okay. And the enemy might come in there in a way to abort the dreams in our lives, the plans of God in our lives, or the vision that God has placed in our spirit. But thank God, Joseph stood on his grounds. He did not take heed to what this lady was doing. And in the end, the woman lied about Joseph of a rape which Joseph did not do. She had a good evidence that proved that Joseph did it, yet God knows that he did not do. Sometimes you've been lied about, you've said things that you have not done, and there's no way that you can defend yourself. But I want to encourage you today that God alone knows, and one day the truth will come out. All that the Bible says is that be still and know that I am God. And the thing that the enemy has planned for evil, God will turn it out for your good. Joseph was sent out into the prison for doing nothing. In the prison, God was still working out things in his own way. Plans were being unfolded, and the dream that brought him to captivity. Somebody had a dream that he interpreted, and then he wanted to rely on that person, that the person should remember him, help him to be delivered from the prison. The person went and forgot about Joseph entirely. But it happened that the king of Egypt had a dream which he could not understand the meaning. But the only person who could interpret the dream was Joseph. That was the day that that man remembered Joseph. God was doing something in the life of Joseph at that time, that Joseph would not put his trust in men. Because the Bible says that cursed is anyone who trusts in man. He was trying to trust man for his deliverance, that he would be released. But as he went on to continue to trust the Lord, God in his own timing caused Joseph to be brought out from the prison. And as he interpreted the king's dream and then gave them wisdom, direction, how to go about the dream, how things would be okay, the king looked around and saw that there was no one so wise as Joseph who could be able to bring to pass what the Lord has shown him. And he said that, Joseph, from today, you are going to be second in command. Everything in Egypt is in your hands. Whatever you will say is final. Go ahead and then execute what you have said. And that was the beginning of the reign of Joseph. And that was the unfolded dream of Joseph coming to pass. Dream took him to captivity, and dream brought him to the place that God has ordained. If he has not come to Egypt, that dream would have not been fulfilled. Egypt was the location of the place of his lifting. And God orchestrated things that he would be there. There are some people that God orchestrated and bring them to a particular place for the fulfillment of the plan that he has for their lives. But it is not all for everyone. God has a good plan for each and everyone. So all that we need is to locate where God wants us to be. Some people might be in the wrong place. They will do all that they can and they don't see the blessings of God. Get to the right place. Listen to God. Let God speak to you where you have to be. Sometimes it will cost you your job by shifting from your job to something else to be able to see the blessings of God. Sometimes it will mean shifting from your location, the place that you are, to another place before the blessings of God can manifest. God is specific and also with his timing. So God has every details of your life. All that we need to do is to hear from God what he wants us to do, as he spoke to Elijah. Go to the brooks. When the brooks dry, leave the brook, the riverside, and go to Zarephath, where I commanded somebody to sustain you. So as we hear from God and we get to the right place in the right time, we will not be in trouble. We will not be frustrated in life, but we're going to enjoy the blessings of God. God is going to fulfill what he has said. Abraham was a source in his obedience. The whole earth is blessed. The Bible says that all those who believe the Lord Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior are also qualified to enjoy the Abrahamic blessings, that through him the whole families of the earth receive their blessings because of obedience, costing him where he stayed, his comfort zone. He has to leave all these places. Sometimes it will cost you even to leave the church that you are, because God might not need you in that particular place anymore. Or sometimes God might want to lift you to a higher place than where you are. Sometimes it will be shifting from one business to the other in order to receive the blessings of God. But the most important thing is to hear from the Lord. As we pay attention to hear from God, and in, at the right time and in the right location, we are going to receive the blessings of God. We are going to enjoy the fullest blessings of God in every area of our life.